Hello, my name is Kamil, I'm CEO and founder of Riverdi. Today I will be presenting you a new display in our offer, which is HDMI display. First of all, let's talk why do we need HDMI interface and why it's interesting. So most of the computer out there, like from personal computers to industrial boards, they are typically equipped with one or more HDMI connectors, which make them very easy to connect to HDMI display or any kind of monitor or TV. For particular purposes. So if you need an extra display to be connected to your system and you don't want to play with LVDS, RGB signals, and you have already a computer or you plan to use an industrial or, as I mentioned, even personal computer that will have HDMI, we now have one more display in our offer, which is 5-inch HDMI display, additionally to already 7-inch and 10-inch that we already have in our offer. So this kind of display is, as I mentioned, very easy to use. So why we needed to connect to any system, but actually one more thing worth to mention here is if we have HDMI display, it is very easy to test our display in general and the touch screen. Why? It's because all of our displays are made with the same TFT glass, IPS glass for this particular reason, and high brightness, which is 1000 candela brightness. And if you plan to use our display in your application, maybe you would like to test it first. So HDMI is a super easy way to just buy HDMI display, connect it to your PC, and test how a display works for you, either outdoor or indoor, with maybe testing some gloves, etc., with our touch. This is very easy with the HDMI board. Okay, so let's jump into the display itself. I have a sample here. If you will buy one piece, it will be packed like this. So in a single box packing. So of course we expect a display inside. So let me take it out. Okay, I have a display here. This one is a 5-inch equipped with the UX Touch touchscreen, optically bonded. So as you can see, it's pretty dark in all area because there are no internal reflections because we removed the air. This is the most advanced version of this display, which is recommended for any project. And on the back, of course, there is HDMI board, and we can focus for a second here what we see on the board. So basically, of course, we have a HDMI connector, typical A-type, so the standard one connector. Then we have a USB-C, and this one has a two purposes. So via USB-C, of course, we can connect the touchscreen, but also we can power up the display. So actually, to make this display run, we just need two cables, will be HDMI and then USB-C. Additional to that, we have a small Molex connector here, which is described as a power and PMW. And here we can also connect the power to the display, but additionally, we can change the brightness. As I mentioned, the display is pretty bright. It's 1000 candela. And in some application, for example, it's outdoor application, and during the night, maybe we would like to decrease the brightness so we can use the PMW signal from your system to change the brightness of a display. And we have one more connector. We have typical jack DC connector where we can connect also the power. So why we need so many connectors for the power? As I mentioned, we may use only USB, but maybe we don't have USB in our system or we don't have enough power. Please check the power consumption of the display in the datasheet. So if we don't use a USB, then we can use the Molex or we can use a DC connector for powering up the display. Okay, so let's play with it now. I will connect it. So first I will connect the HDMI connector, and then let me connect the USB. And now the display is powered up. As you can see here, I have some background prepared there as an application. So you can see this. Of course, the touch is working, so I can play with this image. It works immediately as a plug and play. So we don't need any drivers. This is super easy. display to be used, because all the information are stored in the memory of a display, so the computer recognizes what kind of touch is there, what is the resolution for the touch, and what is resolution for the display, and is let's say setting up correctly without anything from my side. Yes, it will work basically with Linux or Windows system, where we have the typical plug-and-play drivers for HDMI display. As I mentioned, we can power it from the USB. This is happening right now, but actually I can connect DC connector with the power. Nothing is happening because display is created in a way that is selecting which voltage is higher, which power is higher. In this case, now we are switching to DC connector because I use 12 volt. But actually we have a predefined range. Yes, if we look onto the board, there is 7 to 36 volt range of the power for this display. So very wide range of power supply, so it's easy to use in any industrial system. So now I can unplug the USB, but the display is still running, of course. So now I don't have the touch functionality, but I can have the image and the power only. Okay, so as always, when you buy Riverdi display, you will not only get the industrial grade display, but you will also get all the accessories. So that means different versions. So this one is a touch version, but you can buy display with no touch. Like this one here is a 5-inch no touch display with the mounting frame. You can buy it without this mounting frame. If you go to our website, you will see all the options. I will show it this in a second. Additionally to the display itself, on our website you will find also accessories like HDMI cable or USB C cable if you need. And as you may notice, the display for 5-inch is pretty small, and then there is not much space, so you will be able to find on our offer also the right angle HDMI cable. If I will connect it here, you can see it's taking way less space, yes, from a display, so it's easier to connect this kind of a display that is pretty small with the HDMI cable. So now let's go to the website, because it's also interesting what we will see there. Now I am on the Riverdi.com website. I will go to HDMI products. Let's see what we have there. When we record this video, there is no 5-inch on the website yet, but when you watch it, actually the 5-inch should be already there, so please go and check yourself the 5-inch documentation. But I will take 7-inch as an example to show you, because we built every display in the same way. So first of all, what you will notice will be 7-inch several models, or 5-inch in our case. You will see the most sophisticated version, so it's a C00-B, that means it's an optically bonded display. You see, it's a little bit more expensive than non-optically bonded display with UX touch, with the same touch. Then we have the standard regular touch with the frame. So this one is a type of the touch, which is the size of a display. Typically, when you mount a display from the inside, this is useful. Or we have the touch version with no frame, and then no touch, two versions, frame and no frame. No touch version. You can also notice that even if it's no touch version, the USB connector is there, USB-C, so still you can power up the display even if there is no touch with the USB, with simple two cables to the computer. Okay, so let's jump into the 7-inch optically bonded, which is similar to our 5-inch that I have into the offer, and let me see what is inside. Okay, I'm on the 7-inch right now, and you may notice here that we have a data sheet, we have the drawing, of course, we have a 3D model, and then we have option to customize. We can also select other options from here, and you can see that there is like a small help to explain every option, what does it mean to use this or other option. And what is missing here is EMI report. We are working on that as well. So soon for 7-inch and for 5-inch, there will be a EMI report showing the emission of a display. Because we always build our displays with a low EMI to be used in industrial or even medical projects possible. So we are testing them first and designing in a way to pass the basic certification levels. And so that will be added soon. Okay, so that will be all for today. I hope you enjoy the video and you like this kind of content. Please click the like button. Please subscribe to our channel to see more video like that and to be always up to date with our latest information and products. Thank you for listening, and I hope to see you with another video.